Girls, your friend Hannah is here, and welcome to Kindergarten Sabbath School Lesson. Today, we have a wonderful story for you. But before that, I invite you to check this out. Today's lesson is entitled, The Little Maid Serve God. But before that, come on boys and girls, it's our sing-along time. Let's praise the Lord together. Today's lesson is entitled, The Little Maid Serve God. But before that, come on boys and girls, it's our sing-along time. Let's praise the Lord together.
Little children.
Today's lesson is entitled, The Little Maid, Serve God. The memory verses, may God strengthen you in every good deed and word. 2 Thessalonians 2:16 and 17. Let's repeat it again. May God strengthen you in every good deed and word. 2 Thessalonians 2:16 and 17. Let's repeat it one more time. May God strengthen you in every good deed and word. 2 Thessalonians 2:16 and 17. Now it's your turn. Good job, everyone. Thank you. The message for today's story is we serve God by what we do and say. Before the lesson, I invite you to pray with me. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for this day as we're going to study our lesson about the little maid serve God. Be with us and speak to us in Jesus' name. Amen. Do you know how to serve God? The little maid served God by what she did and said. The little slave girl carefully lifted the perfume bottles and dusted them. The bottles usually sparkled through the light that streamed through the bedroom windows, but not today. Today the curtains were closed, and Mrs. Nan was sitting in her bed in the darkness crying softly. The little maid knew why. Captain Naaman had leprosy. The leprosy made white spots on his skin, and he cannot feel things with his fingers and toes. And this made Mrs. Naaman very, very sad. The little maid tiptoed quietly to the bed. I wish Master Naaman would go to see the prophet in my country, she whispered. Prophet Elisha would heal him of his leprosy. Mrs. Naaman wiped her eyes. What? What are you talking about, child? She asked. Then the little maid told her exactly all about the prophet Elisha who lived in Israel. The Lord of Heaven works miracles through the prophet Elisha, she said. Then she told Mrs. Naaman all she had learned from her parents about the true and living God. Mrs. Naaman scooted off the bed. Bring me some water to wash my face, she said. I must talk with my husband. Captain Naaman was the commander of the king's army. So Naaman told the king what the little maid had told his wife. Go, said the king. Go and visit the prophet. I'll send a letter to the king of Israel for you. Captain Naaman took with him gold coins and 10 sets of beautiful clothes with him. These would be gifts to the people in Israel who helped him. But when the king of Israel wrote the letter from the king of Syria, he was very troubled. He was deeply troubled. The king of Israel knew that he could not heal Naaman. He didn't understand why the king of Syria thought he could heal Naaman. He was very worried. What if Naaman wasn't healed? Would the king of Syria attack Israel again? Prophet Elisha heard about Naaman's visit. Elisha sent Israel's king a message. Why are you so upset? Have Naaman come and visit me, and you will know that there is a prophet in Israel. Prophet Elisha knew that he couldn't heal Naaman, but God could. Prophet Elisha and the little maid both wanted Captain Naaman to know about the true God. The little maid showed her love of God as she helped Mrs. Naaman in everything she said. She loved to share God with others. And you can serve God too by what you do and say. That is how others will know that you love God. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for this day. Thank you for the lesson. Help us to serve you in everything we do and say. Be with those who are watching. May you be with them, protect them, and keep them safe. Be with those who are sick. May you lay your healing hand upon them and restore their health. In Jesus' name, amen. Today, boys and girls, remember, we serve God by what we do and say. Thank you for watching, and thank you for subscribing to my YouTube channel. May God be with y'all. Have a blessed week and happy Sabbath. See you next time. Bye.